Dear viewers, welcome to our channel GVS Bank Academy. Today I am going to discuss about promotional exams, memory based recalled questions, scale 4 to 5, August 2021, Indian Overseas Bank examination questions. These are the question number 1, interest equalization scheme on free shipment and forced shipment. Rupee export rate. Interest equalization rate is 5% in respect of exports in the micro, small and medium enterprises sector. Manufacturers, MSME manufacturing sector, 5%. And MSME related merchant trading exporters, 3% they will get the interest subvention. That is called interest equalization. For MSME manufacturing exporters 5, others merchant traders exporters, that is 3%. Outsourcing of cash management, reconciliation of transactions, ATM cash replenishment. Reconciliation of transactions shall be done between the bank and the service provider and its subcontract at least on transaction date plus 3. 3 plus 3 basis reconciliation of transactions shall be done between the bank, the service provider and its subcontract at least on T plus 3 basis. This is RBI circular dated 14/5/2019. Now and in AMA, M stands for Advanced Measurement Approach. M stands for M, measurement. Advanced Measurement Approach means this is one of the operational risk management method. For calculation of operational risk, we are using three methods presently. One is basic indicator approach, that method we are using now. Second method is standardized approach. Third method is advanced measurement approach. Now, they are asked operational risk advanced measurement approach, AMA, advanced measurement approach. This is it. This is one of the method of operational risk management system in the banks. SHG grading based on SHG grading. At the time of giving loans to SHG, these SHGs are graded on Panchasutras. SHG should be practicing Panchasutras. Regular, what are the five principles? Regular meeting, regular saving, regular interloaning among the members, timely repayment of loans in between and to the bank also, and up-to-date maintenance of books. These are the five basic Panchasutras for the SHG. Based on these principles only, SHGs are going to be rated. These norms fixed by NABARD. SHG grading, the same question was also asked in 2020 OBC examination also, they had asked a scale 5 to 6. Now, if they are getting more than 90 marks, A grade, SHGs more than 90, A grade, 75 to up to 90%, B grade, 60 to 75%, C grade. Minimum grade required for getting bank loan for SHG, that is at least C grade is required. So, A above 90, more than 90, 75 to up to 90, B grade, 60 to 75, C grade. This is the SHG grading principles. Now, fifth question. Budget allocation for financial year 2021-22 for MSME sector. Budget allocation for the financial year 21-22 for MSME sector, 15,700 crores. 2021, that is 7572. This is the 15,700 crores for the current year. 21-22, this is. Agriculture Infrastructure Fund, this is the budget initiation in 2020 scheme. Now, under this scheme, government allotted 1 lakh crores investment, 1 lakh crores financing activity, 1 lakh crores, up to 1 lakh crores. Credit guarantee for loans up to 2 crores given by CGT MSC. The fee for this coverage will be paid by the government only. So loan up to 2 crores cover under CGTMSC, and the fee for this coverage will be paid by the government. This is second point. Third point, interest subvention of 3% per annum. They are getting interest subvention up to 2 crores, 3% per project in one location, though loan amount can be higher. Interest subvention, you will get 3% per annum, limited to 2 crores per project in one location. Now, if you are taking more locations, you will get accordingly. Interest subvention will be available for a maximum period of 7 years. The 3% up to 2 lakhs available up to 7 years interest subvention. One eligible entity organization puts up projects in different location. In different locations, not only different locations, then all such projects will be eligible under the scheme for loan up to 2 crores. So one company or an organization, they can put up projects in so many areas, locations. But all such projects will be eligible for under this scheme 2 crores rupees. For a private sector entity such as farmer, agriculture entrepreneur, startup, there will be a limit of maximum 25. So private organizations, farmers, agriculture entrepreneurs, startup, they can start 25 such projects in 25 locations. Moratorium, minimum 6 months and a maximum period of 2 years. So for repayment, they are giving a moratorium period of 6 months to 2 years. Disbursement will complete in 6 years from 20 to 21. It was initiated in 20 to 21. From the date of this, the disbursement will complete in 6 years for plan. This question is very, very important for new scheme. This is the Government of India new scheme for development of agriculture infrastructure development. This is the allocation is 1 lakh crores. This is very, very important. Now, at the time of need-based refinance, support will be made available by NABARD. If any bank want to refinance from NABARD, yes, they can avail the refinance facility. This is about the agriculture. For approval of CARP, Corporate Insolvency Resolution Process under IBC code, Insolvency and Bankruptcy code, for approval of CARP, Corporate Insolvency Resolution Plan shall be approved with the consent of 66% of Committee of Creditors. That Committee of Creditors means lenders, financial creditors is required. Any approval under CARP for approval of the plan, 66% of lenders, Committee of Creditors approval is required. For any CARP, 66% of consent is not available, the account will go to the company, the unit will go to liquidation. So minimum consent required is 66% for approval of CARP under Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code. That is it. Advance remittance for import of goods without any bank guarantee from a bank. How much an importer can remit advance without any guarantee or security? That is there. For goods up to $2 lakh, he can remit without any bank guarantee from domestic or international accepted organizations for goods, and for services up to $5 lakh, he can remit advance remittance. For import of goods, 2 lakh, he can remit. For services, up to 5 lakhs without any bank guarantee. This is very important question. Trade credit also, they had asked one question. Trade credit already we had uploaded a separate YouTube channel. Question number 9, Sovereign Gold Bond Scheme. Sovereign Gold Bond Scheme, trust how much maximum they can subscribe in a financial year. Now, maximum limit for subscription for 20 cases for trust and similar entities notified by the government in a fiscal year. Minimum 1 gram, maximum 4 cases for individual, and maximum 20 cases for trust and societies where it is registered. And further guidelines we had already uploaded. The link is This one is the link for sovereign gold bond scheme. Diamond dollar account. This diamond dollar account shall be opened in the name of exporter and maintained in US dollar in current account. This is the current account in the who are eligible only exporters. Exporters with track record of at least 2 years, good track record for 2 years in the export of diamonds, colored gemstones, diamond and color gemstones, studded jewelry, etc. And having an annual average annual turnover 3 crores or above during the preceding three licensing. During preceding three licensing, average turnover is 3 crores and good track record from the last 2 years. This is one of the basic condition for opening up diamond dollar account by the exporters who are dealing with diamonds, gemstones, etc. Permitted to open 5 DDA current accounts in dollar, 5 accounts. And whatever the balances are there in DDA account, that on that balance banks has to maintain, subject to, these balances are subject to CRR and SLR. Bank has to maintain CRR and SLR. Question number 11. Guidelines for reporting fraud to police, CBI, public sector banks. Public sector banks. In almost all banks, they are giving this question. Now, we are divided into 4 parts. One is fraud up to below 30 million means 3 lakhs, 3 crores. 30 million and above up to 250 million means 25 crores. 3 crores to 25 crores. More than 25 crores to up to 50 crores. More than 50 crores. 500 million means 50 crores. This is it. Now, below 30 million means below 3 crores fraud. If committed by staff, we can file with state police. Below 30 million means up to less than 3 crores. State police, if committed by staff. If committed by other than staff, state economic offenses wing or CID department, we can file of the state concerned. This is up to below 3 crores. 3 crores and above and up to 25 crores, means 250 million, 25 crores. CBI to be lodged with the anti-corruption bureau, where staff involvement is there. CBI, anti-corruption branch of CBI. Where staff involvement is there, 3 crores to 25 crores. Where staff involvement is not there, CBI, economic offenses wing. This question they had asked in the IOB examination, this question. Loan given for 18 crores and staff involvement is not there. Where we can file? CBI, economic offenses wing. This is the exam question. So loan amount is, fraud is 18 crores. CBI, economic offenses wing. Where staff prime facie, staff involvement is not there. Now, 25 crores, more than 25 crores, and up to 50 crores. To CBI to be lodged with banking security and fraud cell of CBI. Banking security and fraud cell of CBI, irrespective of the involvement of public servant or not. So, for all cases 25 crores and above and up to 50 crores, we can file with banking security and fraud cell. Banking security and fraud cell. Now, more than 50 crores, fraud amount is more than 50 crores, to be lodged with the joint director, policy, CBI, headquarter, New Delhi. More than 50 crores and above, to be lodged with the joint director, policy, CBI, headquarter, New Delhi. This is about the guidelines for reporting of frauds. Special committee of the board. Banks are required to constitute a special committee of the board for monitoring and follow-up of cases of frauds involving amount of 10 million, 1 crore and above frauds bank should form a special committee of the board for monitoring and follow-up. This is also applicable to banks. This is about fraud reporting, very, very important for all bank examinations. Question number 12, detection of counterfeit notes. Detection of counterfeit notes, reporting to police and other bodies. Now, detection of counterfeit notes in a single transaction, counterfeit notes up to four in a single transaction, monthly consolidated report to police authority through nodal officer of the bank. In a single transaction, 5 and above, immediately bank has to file the FIR through bank nodal officer to police authorities. This is about reporting. The detailed guidelines are uploaded through this YouTube link. Currency chest, opening of currency chest. This question is intelligently they are asked. Currency chest, reimbursement of capital expenditure and revenue cost in metro areas, not eligible. RBI is not interested for giving a reimbursement of capital and revenue expenditure in metro areas. Where RBI is giving, where opening of currency chest less than 1 lakh population areas and that too unbanked areas. In that areas, banks are getting capital expenditure reimbursement and revenue expenditure also we are getting. In the unbanked areas, population less than 1 lakh, banks are getting 50% of the capital expenditure reimbursement. Maximum cap is 50 lakhs. In northeastern states, you will get 100% of the capital expenditure subject to 50 lakhs. This is for reimbursement of capital expenditure. Revenue expenditure, establishment of currency chest in unbanked and population less than 1 lakh. First 3 years, banks will get the revenue expenditure reimbursement. And in northeastern areas, 5 years, they will get the reimbursement of revenue expenditure. Detailed current chest matters, detailed analysis was discussed through this link uploaded. Question number 14, penalties for bank branches for violation of agreement with RBI in case of more than 5 violations. Now, this is also very important circular. Any violation with the RBI agreement, bank, if they are continuously violating for more than 5 times, penalty is 5 lakhs. First violation, 10,000. And frequently they are violating. If that violations are more than 5 times, 5 lakhs. In addition to 5 lakhs penalty, they have to disclose separately in the website. This was also discussed through this link fully. Through this link fully, we had discussed. Now, ANBC calculation, adjusted net bank credit calculation, priority sector, also discussed through this link fully. Adjusted net bank credit calculation, through this website we had already discussed and uploaded. And question number 16, break-even point calculation, one case study. Now, so these are the practical case studies, ANBC calculation and break-even point calculation. Break-even point means no profit, no loss situation. And further, break-even point formula is fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. Contribution per unit is equal to selling price per unit minus variable cost. This is about the break-even point calculation. These are some of the questions which are important for the forthcoming promotion examination also. These questions are very useful for the participants who are appearing for the other banks examination in the December, January, February months, coming month. Thank you very much, friends, for watching our YouTube channel regularly. Thank you very much.